Hello everyone, this is SQL Depository. I am Saras Pandey and this is video number 2 on Postgres administration. In this video, we will deploy an AWS Ubuntu EC2 machine and EC2 VM, where in the next video, we will deploy or we will install Postgres. So for this, I will open a browser and I will search for AWS portal. Click on the first link and if you already have an account, you can use that account, but if you don't have any AWS account, then you can click on create a free account and you will have to provide a few details and then your credit card or debit card details and then you are done. For this video, I will use a free VM. So you will not have to pay any money for this entire series of video. But I will use a public IP so that I can use that machine. I can access that VM from my laptop or desktop. And for this, you will have to pay a minimal amount of money, which will not be more than $1 or $2 for the entire series of video. So it should not be too much for learning, right? So I already have an account. So I will click on sign in. And once it will be open, I will log in as a root user. So my root user email ID is this. And then click on next. Then provide your password. And after you will provide the password, you will log into AWS Management Console. So right now I'm in the Frankfurt region and this is the region that I want to use. But in your case, if you want to use any other region, this is fine. You can use any of the AWS regions. Okay. So here I want to deploy a virtual machine where I will have Linux Ubuntu installed, right? But for this, I will first have to create a virtual private network and the subnet. However, AWS provide a default network and subnet in every AWS region, but I'm not going to use that. I will instead deploy my own AWS, virtual private network and subnet, and then I will complete the networking so that I will be able to access that VM from my laptop. So for this, first I'll have to go to VPC. Right now I'm already in VPC, but if you are not inside VPC right now, then all that you have to do is you will have to search for VPC and then click on it. Now, once this page will be loaded, you will be able to see that there is already a network, which is the default network that AWS has created. If you have not already created your own networks, so you can see there is one network. I will click on VPCs and once I am inside it, I will go ahead and click on create VPC. I will have to provide a name to my VPC. So I will say FRA-VPC01. Okay. Then I will have to provide a range of IP for my network. So that will be 192.168.0.0/24, and 24 is the net mask. So if you'll see the first part of the IP, this IP is in four part and every part represent an octet. Octet means 8 bits, right? So out of these 32 bits, 8, then 8, 8, and the last octet is also 8, which makes it 32 bit. Out of these 32 bit, I have masked 24 bits, which means I can only change last 8 bits, right? So let me actually open one more link, which is IT subnet calculator. And here I can go to any link. Let me go to this one and let me provide my range of IP. So this is the IP and this is the netmask, and I will click on calculate. Here you can see the total number of available hosts are 254. So as I already told you that I can only change the last octet. So it will vary from 0 to 255, which makes it 256 different IPs, right? But the first IP will always be used in for the network and the last IP for the broadcast. So these are total 256 IPs, but two IPs has been taken by network and broadcast, then you only have 254 IPs left, right? Okay. So let me go ahead and create this VPC. Now, as your VPC is created, you will have to create your one subnet on that VPC so that you can deploy a VM on that subnet. So I will click on the subnet here and then click on the create subnet. Then select your VPCs. So this is the VPC that I have created just now. I will select that. Then you will have to provide a sub name of the subnet. So I would say FRA subnet 01-public, because I'm going to create a public subnet here. When I say public subnet, which means that whatever VMs will be created on the top, on this subnet, there will be a public IP assigned to it until unless you are not manually selecting it not to assign. Okay. Then in the availability zone, you have three different availability zones. You can select any one of them, but I'm just leaving it to no preferences so that now I'm leaving it to AWS and it can create my subnet on any of these availability zones, right? Now, I will have to provide a range of IP, and this range of IP should be the subset of the VPC that I've just created. So I would say 192.168.0.0/28. I've changed my netmask. For my VPC, I've selected 24, but this time I've selected 28. So let me actually go ahead and check what are the range of IPs that I will get when I will select netmask as 28. So I will go back to IP calculator and change the netmask to 28 and click on calculate. You can see that I have total number of 14 hosts available, and the first IP of this subnet will be 192.168.0.0, and the last IP will be 192.168.0.15. But as I've already told you, in every subnet, the first IP will be the network IP, the last IP will be the broadcast IP. So these two IPs has been taken already. Now, out of the 16 IPs that you have in this subnet, only 14 host IPs are available. So you can maximum deploy 14 host. So I will go ahead and create this subnet. And now this subnet has been created. And if I scroll little right, and I want you to look at this column, available IP 4 addresses. Here you can see 11, not 14. So one IP has been taken by network, one IP has been taken by broadcast, but still you should have 14 IPs, but here it is showing 11. This is because AWS is utilizing three more IPs, one for the DNS, one for the extra networking, and one for the future purpose. Okay, so whenever you will create any subnet in AWS, AWS will utilize total 5 IPs. So this is what happening here, and that is why you have only 11 IPs available. But I want to use only one IP, so this is good enough for me. Okay, now as I have the subnet, I can deploy the virtual machine on it. So I will search for the VM or EC2 and click on EC2. And then I'll click on instances. Then I will click on launch instance. I will have to provide a name to my instance. So I will say psql. You can give any other name that you want. It is not mandatory to give psql. And then in the image, I will select Ubuntu, and you can see that Ubuntu server 22.04 LTS, and this is free tier eligible. So you don't have to pay anything for this. And then under the instance type, it is t2.micro because this is free tier eligible. But if you want to change the instance type, you can do that, but then you will have to pay some money for this. For me, it is not required, so I'm not going to change it. Then under the key pair, if you already have the key pair in the region, this is region based, then you can select that, but I don't have any. So I will go ahead and click on create new key pair. And then I will have to provide a name. I would say FRA VM. Under the key pair type, I will leave it as RSA and .PEM. Then I will click on create key pair. As soon as you will click on create key pair, it will download the key pair under the downloads. Scroll down under the network setting. You can see it has already selected a network, but this is the default AWS network. But I don't want to use that. I want to use the network that I have created just now. So I will click on edit, and then from the drop down, I will select my network that I have created just now. Then in the subnet, it has already selected the subnet that I have created. Now, I forgot to make this subnet as public subnet, but that is always okay because you have the option to enable the public IP. So here you can see auto assign public IP. It was actually disabled, but I have changed it to enable. So now when I will create the VM, it will actually go ahead and assign a public IP to my virtual machine. Okay, which is good. It has already selected the subnet because I have only one subnet, but if you have multiple subnets, you can always go ahead and select the correct subnet from the drop down list. Now I will scroll down, and here I will have to provide security group name. So here you can see create security group is already selected, where I can go ahead and create a new security group. But you already have created the security group, then you can select this one, and from the drop down you can select the security group. Right now I have only one security group, which is the default one, and I don't want to use that. So I will click again on create security group and give a name to my security group. The name would be FRA-SG-01. You can give any name that you want. And in the description, I would say FRASG, right? So now it is already creating a firewall rule, inbound rule for SSH that machine. And in the source type, it has given anywhere, which means that your machine will be accessible from any IP. But I don't want to do that because I don't want anyone to, use my VM. So what I'll do, I will select my IP here, and it will automatically detect my IP and select that, and it has already done that. So I will scroll down. Under the configure storage, you can see that 8 GB GP2 storage is selected, but under this you can see this message: free tier eligible customer can get up to 30 GB EBS. So up to 30 GB is free, then I will go ahead and increase the EBS volume to just say 25 GB, which should be good enough for this series of video. And then I don't want to change anything. There are advanced details. If you want to go through it, you can always go ahead and go through it, but I am not going to change anything here. So I will click on launch instance. Now, this will take a little time for the instance to be available. So for that duration, I will pause this video, and once the instance is available, I'll resume the video again. Okay, so my instance is ready now. I will select this instance, click on connect, click on SSH client, scroll down, and you can see the example here. Just copy this, open command prompt, and the PEM file that I've created, the key pair, it is under download, so I will redirect it to downloads folder. Now I will paste it, but I'm not expecting this to connect because my networking is not yet completed. So it should ideally connection timed out, but we will wait for this to happen. It should not take much time. In another few seconds, it should show the error message. Okay, so now you can see it is already connection timed out. This is because we have created the subnet, and then we have already assigned a public IP to the virtual machine, but that doesn't mean that you can access it from anywhere. We have created the firewall rule as well. Okay, but then still there is few things that you have to do in order to access it from your laptop or desktop. So for this, I will go back to VPC. Click on VPC. And once it is under VPC dashboard, I will click on Internet Gateways, because I'm accessing this virtual machine over the internet. So there has to be an internet gateway to access it, but it is not yet created. So what I'll do, I'll click on Create Internet Gateway, give a name to Internet Gateway. So I would say FRA IGW01. And then click on Create Internet Gateway. Now the Internet Gateway has been created, so I will click on Actions, click on Attach to VPC, and then I will select the VPC that I have just created, and then click on Attach Internet Gateway. Now Internet Gateway has been created, the VPC is attached. Still, I will have to provide a route using Internet Gateway. So for this, I will have to go to root tables. Click on the root tables. Click on edit root tables if you want to create new. But whenever you create a VPC, actually AWS create a root table for that VPC. And if you scroll little right, expand this, you can see this. This is the VPC that I've created just now, and there is already a root table. So why don't we just go ahead and edit this root table. I will give a proper name to this root table. I would say FRA RT01. Okay, then I will select this root table and click on Actions, and then click on Edit Roots. Now you can see that this is my VPC IP range, right? So the entire range of IP for this VPC is already added. So root for all the IPs in the VPC has already been created. So whatever VMs you are deploying in this particular virtual private network, you don't have to create the root for it. But for Internet Gateway, I will click on Add Root. I will whitelist all the IPs, so I will select 0.0.0/0, which means the entire IP range, and then here I will select Internet Gateway. So it will give me the Internet Gateway that I have just created, and I will select that. I will click on Save Changes, and then I'm done. Now if I'll go back to my command prompt and then run the same command again, it should ideally connect this time. It is asking me, are you sure you want to continue? I would say yes. And you are done. You are connected to your Ubuntu VM. So this is what I wanted to cover in this session. In the next session, we will use this VM to deploy, or we will install Postgres, and then we will also do some configuration changes in the VM, right? So I will see you again in the next video. Thank you for watching this one.